week of Engage here at Lord of Life. We hope that you're ready to dive into the Word, to share some faith together, and then to be sent back out to encounter the world around us. Hey, a few announcements for us as we get going. First, this Sunday, January 24th, will be our annual meeting here at Lord of Life, where we'll be spending time together talking about our budget for the coming year, electing new officers to our council, our church leadership team, and making sure that we're all on the same page as we're moving forward in God's mission. So please plan to join us at 1 p.m. this Sunday, 1 p.m. January 24th. Make sure to be a part of that process. Also coming up, we have our Super Bowl of Caring. It's going to look different than it has in years past, but watch the happenings email for details on how we're going to continue that great event. Those are all the announcements for us. So now I invite you to gather with whoever you're with and come together as we begin to engage our faith.
Here, reading from the book of Jonah, chapter 3. The word of the Lord came to Jonah a second time, saying, "Get up and go to Nineveh, that great city, and proclaim to it the message that I tell you." So Jonah sent out and went to Nineveh according to the word of the Lord. Now Nineveh was an exceedingly large city, a 3 days walk across. Jonah began to go into the city, going a day's walk. And he cried out, 40 days more, and Nineveh will be overthrown." And the people of Nineveh believed God. They proclaimed a fast, everyone great and small, and put on sackcloth. And towards the end of the chapter, verse 10, "When God saw what they did, how they turned from their evil ways, God changed his mind about the calamity that he said he would bring upon them. And he did not do it." It all sounds very predictable, doesn't it? However, My friend Don Quixote tells a different story. When you think of a mule, you think of being stubborn. And really, the backstory to Jonah is not the valiant prophet who preached God's word, but a stubborn prophet who did not want to do what God asked. In fact, so much so, we know that he went in the opposite direction from Nineveh, that he was on a ship and he'd rather be thrown over and drowned rather than do what God wanted him to do. Stubborn. Stubborn, as we say, is poor Don Quixote here as a mule. Why was he so stubborn? Well, he could not wrap his head around the idea that God would actually help those poor Ninevites, those sinners who were hated by the people of Israel. They were not God's people. Why would God do that? But God does. And indeed, the story of Jonah shows that God had a great sense of love for all people. In a book by Thomas John Carlyle, You Jonah, a series of poems on the book of Jonah, he speaks of this situation where God spares Nineveh. It's called limitation. God changed God's mind because they had changed their hearts. God repented because they repented. That is the way we word it sometimes. But always God is limited only by God's limitless love. One of the great challenges for us is to see the big picture of God's love for all people. As Jonah had a hard time even envisioning it, that God would help people not like him, may you and I always be open to that limitless love. And limitless love not just for us, but for others. And not be stubborn as a mule. May God help us and may God guide us to be not only recipients of God's love, but to share God's unlimited love. Amen.
Welcome back. You know, it's in this meal that even the most stubborn of us are invited to encounter that same grace that was being extended to the Ninevites, that boundless, limitless grace of God that is extended out to each and every one of us. And so we remember that on the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. All are invited to this table here at Lord of Life, even the most stubborn Don Quixotes. We're all invited to this table. So wherever you are, whoever you are gathered with, we invite you to take this bread and use the words, "the body of Christ given for you," and to take this wine or grape juice and to use the words, "the blood of Christ shed for you." So now come to the table where all are welcome.
Thank you.
All right, that's all for us here at Engage this week. We hope you have an opportunity to take this faith out, not to be stubborn like Don Quixote, but to encounter something new and see what God is up to in the world around you. So now receive this blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace to serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.